Turtle Nerds, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I want to talk to you guys about a very important topic, identifying and treating shell rot in turtles. I've gotten a lot of messages from you guys asking, is this shell rot? Is this a hard water stain? What is this? How do I treat it? How do I take care of it? And is this something that I even need to worry about? So I'm hoping that today's video can answer some of those questions and hopefully clear up some confusion that you guys might be having about what shell rot is and how to prevent it and fix it. Excuse the subpar day, but we're working with what we got here. So when we're talking about shell rot, the first thing that you're going to want to do if you're suspecting that your turtle has it is identifying, you know, is this shell rot or is this something else? So most of the time when someone contacts me and they ask whether or not their turtle has shell rot, it's usually not. If you have clean water and your turtle is basking normally, the combination of clean water and completely drying off their shell periodically or daily is usually enough to keep away shell rot or any type of like fungus or disease. Shell rot is most prevalent in enclosures that are suboptimal or in turtles that are rescued from homes where they were not being taken care of, where they were in dirty water and maybe didn't have optimal basking conditions or no basking spot at all. A lot of the times when someone contacts me, what they think is shell rot or a spot on their shell is actually a hard water stain. Hard water stains are common. I mean, if you're doing the dishes, they're fairly common on old aquariums. When the water starts to evaporate, there's that little bit of sediment on the side of the tank. That is a hard water stain. Essentially, what happens is water comes onto an area, be it the side of an aquarium or your turtle's shell, and it has little minerals and things inside of the water. When the water evaporates, it leaves behind those minerals that then accumulate until you can see it. Now, this can happen also on your turtle's shell. As they come out of the water and go up on a basking platform and bask every day, that water and the buildup of those minerals, they build up and accumulate until you have hard water stains. It's important to note that hard water stains are nothing bad. They're very common. I mean, I've had them on my turtles before. They're really nothing to worry about, and most often you can identify it if it's just like a silvery metallic color. If you take like a toothbrush or like a soft type of material and like sort of scrub a little bit and it comes off, no problem. That's most likely nothing to worry about and just a hard water stain. If you have clean water and your turtle basks normally, odds are it's not shell rot. Shell issues are way more common in terrapins just because normally in the wild, when they're kept in brackish water, that salt acts as a buffer and it usually keeps away any fungus or bacteria that would cause ailments to the turtle's shell. So when you keep your terrapins in fresh water, they're a little more susceptible to funguses and bacterial infections. This is usually not a problem if your water is like totally clean and clear. Well, clear doesn't mean clean, but if your water is clean, but still it happens to the best of us sometimes. So something that's way more common in terrapins as far as shell issues are this fungus. It's a fungus that grows between the scutes, which are the individual parts of a turtle shell. So between the topmost layer and the bottom layer, this like white sort of fungus will grow and slowly start to take over the shell. Thankfully, this fungus doesn't do any harm. It just looks like garbage. If we take a look at Bean, you guys know I do everything I can to take proper care of my animals, but Bean started to get this fungus out of nowhere last year, about a year and a half ago, and it took over her entire shell. This is her just like 3 or 4 months back. You can see that it covered her entire shell, and it's only recently started to go away after I put her out in the pond. Natural sunlight and super clean pond water, I think, are the two things that really help to get rid of that fungus. Now, as far as prevention for this type of fungus, we don't really know what causes it. I mean, I would say clean water, but I thought that my water was clean back when I had Bean and everyone in my dorm in my stock tank. I was doing weekly water changes. Sometimes I think that fungus just sort of happens. It's not yet identified where it comes from. A simple fix for that, though, is going to be dry docking and applying an antifungal cream. And we'll talk about what dry docking is shortly when we start identifying shell rot. Okay, so right here you see all the way around those marginal scutes are beautiful. And these two spots that Bean has shed those scutes, that fungus has totally gone away. So now let's talk about shell rot. Like I said, shell rot usually occurs in dirty water and suboptimal conditions. Shell rot is usually visible by pits in the turtle shell where it's sort of being eaten away. It often smells and is soft to the touch. Treating shell rot is usually something that you can do on your own, but it takes a lot of commitment and dedication, and it might require a vet visit if it's severe enough to the point where it's infiltrated way deep into the shell. A vet might need to administer some antibiotics to prevent infection. I would consider shell rot severe if it's taking up a majority of the terrapin shell, and it's more common on the plastron, which is the bottom side of the turtle, than the carapace, which is the top, but it can occur anywhere on the turtle shell. So like I said, it'll be white and soft, and you can dig it out with your nail. And as long as the rot is not that severe, you can usually take care of it at home. Now, as good of care as I take of my animals, we can take a look. And Flipper actually used to have a little bit of rot that we can see has now healed up. Do you see those little pits in her shell? That is where her shell was starting to rot. You can see it's a very clear little divots into her shell. And you can see it's more common on the sides than in the middle of the shell. Now that didn't come from me because Flipper was with someone else before she came to me. Same with Urkel, but he eats and is happy and healthy. So what I'm gonna recommend for shell rot is not an exact science. It's just a general basis of what you should do until you see improvement. Improvement being, you know, you can visibly see that the rot is going away and that there's that white healing and scarring tissue and that the bone is starting to recalcify. So if you notice that your turtle does have shell rot, the first step is to dig out the rot. That's infected bone. You don't want that on your turtle because it will only spread to other spots. So everywhere that you can, you're gonna wanna scrape out that rot and get rid of that nasty stuff. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is take your turtle and dry dock them. Now, dry docking them is just putting them in somewhere with ambient temperatures from 75 to 80 degrees so they don't get too cold and just leaving them out of the water. You can just do this by taking a tub, putting some towels at the bottom and putting them in and leaving them there. After digging out the rot, you're gonna wanna take some type of either antifungal cream or preferably some type of antibiotics to prevent the spread of the infection and begin healing. As far as what kind of antibiotics, I'm not entirely sure, so I don't wanna make any recommendations that could be wrong. I would use something like Betadine and then maybe even just like a normal human triple antibiotic as long as you find out that it's safe for reptiles. Any type of antibiotic, anything to clean out the wound, but I trust Betadine, a diluted Betadine solution, and some type of antibiotic. You're gonna wanna apply that and dry dock them for anywhere from a half hour to an hour to 2 hours, it really depends. And if the shell rot is severe, you're gonna need to dry dock your turtle for longer. They might not even be able to go back in the water. You might need to just soak them in order for them to get their daily water needs, but then keep them dry for the rest of the time if it's severe. Most of the time though, it's just like minor little rots, and then return them back into their enclosure where that water needs to be very, very clean. I would change it nearly daily if you can. And then do the same thing every single day. Eventually, you'll start to notice that it's healing up, and usually this is how you fix shell rot. And honestly, the time that it takes to heal depends on the severity of the rot. So that's generally how you treat shell rot in other turtles. You know, like I said, if it's really severe, you might need to go to the vet for antibiotics. Now, in terrapins, if you're noticing some type of fungus, some type of shell rot or something, terrapins, because they're native to brackish water ecosystems, if you're keeping them in fresh water, they can greatly benefit from brackish water soaking. Because more bacteria and icky nasties can live in fresh water, if you take your terrapin and maybe once a week soak them in some brackish water, that can actually work wonders and heal your terrapin's shell rot without needing any antifungals or creams or even dry docking them. For example, Flipper's little shell rot started to come back and I noticed it started to get a little nasty again. So I soaked her in brackish water, I think for 5 days for about 30 minutes every day. And basking in the sunlight, we can see that they've healed up beautifully. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed, give me a thumbs up to tell me I did a good job. Head on over to my giveaway. I'm giving away a baby terrapin because Bean had some little cutie babies. Hit the subscribe button and the little bell notification thingy so you get notified when I make a new video. Head on over to Patreon to support me if you want to tell me that I'm doing a good job and enter the giveaway. Thank you guys again so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.